painting outside all morning, and he was very hot.
Phew! I'm thirsty.
So he went straight to the fridge.
Ah, a nice jug of cold juice. Hi, Lulu. Would you like a glass too?
Oh, thank you, Morgan. That would be very nice. Morgan, what's happened to you?
Nothing.
But your face, it's all covered in pink spots.
Pink spots? Really?
Yes. Look.
Oh, dear.
You must be sick, Morgan. Maybe we should call a doctor.
Oh.
Ooh. Did you hear that, B1?
I certainly did, B2.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking, B1?
I think I am, B2. It's Dr. Banana's time.
But I don't feel sick at all.
Oh, you're covered in pink spots, Morgan. You must be sick.
Beba, 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 beba.
What seems to be the trouble, Teddies?
Morgan's sick, Dr. Bananas.
The bananas in pyjamas liked being doctors.
Pink spots?
Pink spots could mean you've caught the measles, Morgan.
Or the chicken pox.
Or worse still, not turkey pox, Dr. B1.
I'm afraid it could be turkey pox, Dr. B2.
Oh, you'll have to stay in bed, Morgan.
But I haven't finished painting.
Don't worry, Morgan. You rest and get better, and I'll finish off your painting.
All right. Thank you, Lulu.
So Lulu went outside and finished Morgan's painting. Meanwhile, the Dr. Bananas were taking care of Morgan.
Yes.
How long do I have to stay in bed, Dr. Bananas?
Until the pink spots have gone, I think, Dr. B2.
Ooh.
Don't worry, Morgan. Your painting only took me a minute, and now it's finished.
Oh, dear!
Oh, what's the matter, Dr. Bananas?
I'm sorry, Lulu. I've given you the turkey pox too.
Oh, really? Oh, no.
Where can all those turkey pox be coming from, Dr. B1? I don't know, Dr. B2. But if Morgan went outside and caught the turkey pox, and then Lulu went outside and caught the turkey pox, then
we'd better go outside and look too, Dr. B1.
Good idea, Dr. B2.
So the Dr. Bananas went outside to find out where the turkey pox spots were coming from.
Aha! Here's a pink spotty plant, Dr. B1.
Has the plant got turkey pox too, Dr. B2?
Ooh. Oh dear! The teddy's wheelbarrow's caught it too! This must be very catching, Dr. B1!
Very, very catching, Dr. B2! Now I've got the turkey pox too!
No, you haven't, Dr. B1. You just got pink spots from that pink paintbrush.
Have I?
Now the bananas knew that the turkey pox were just spots of pink paint.
Uh-oh!
After Morgan and Lulu had washed the last of the spots off their faces, they were ready to do some more painting with the banana's help.
Be careful not to splash it on your face, Morgan.
Morgan and Lulu didn't splash a single drop of paint. But the bananas in pyjamas weren't so careful.
Blue spots! You've got the kangaroo pox, B1, and you've got the elephant pox, B2.
But I don't think the bananas were really sick at all. Do you?
Hold still, B2. I've got to practice being a doctor.
Wait, B1.
Hold still, please, B2.
I'm trying to, B1. I'm trying.
Are you ready, B2?
Ready, B1.
Good.
Sorry, B1.
No harm done, B2.
I think I better be the doctor now, B1.
All right, B2.
There.
Ready, B1.
Ready, B2.
I'm sorry, B2.
No harm done, B1. This doctor business can be dangerous, B1.
Very, very dangerous, B2. And it's hard work.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking, B1?
I think I am, B2. It's snack time!
Oh, let's go visit Ratna Hat.
Good idea, B2. Let's go!
Last thing every night, just before he goes to sleep, Rat in a Hat turns off the light, takes off his hat, and puts it on the windowsill next to his bed.
Good night, Hat.
And then he goes straight to sleep. But one night... the next morning, the bananas called into Rat in a Hat's shop.
Morning, Rat!
Hello!
Anyone there?
Oh, that's very odd, B1. Mm.
Very, very odd, B2.
There doesn't seem to be any sign of Rat.
What was that? Is that you, Rat?
Yes, it's me.
What are you doing down there?
And why have you got a towel wrapped around your head?
Because I've lost my hat.
Oh, dear.
That's just a hat, Rat.
B1. I think I am B2. It's hat hunting time.
You wait right there, Rat.
So the bananas set off in search of a hat or rat.
Hi, Maggie. That's a very nice new nest you've got there. Hi, bananas.
Hello, Lulu.
Have you seen Maggie?
I can't stop. Rat's lost his hat, and we're going to find him a new one.
Nest.
Amy thought she might have a hat that would suit Rat.
Oh, I'm sure it's in here somewhere. Ah, here it is.
Ooh.
I think Rat would look very smart in that, don't you?
Well, I suppose we can ask him, B1.
Come on, B2. There's no time to lose. Thanks, Amy.
Thanks, Amy.
That's okay.
Go on, B1. I'm coming, B2.
Hey, bananas! Have you seen Maggie?
Sorry, Lulu.
We've got to show Rat his new hat.
Nest.
What do you reckon, Rat?
Oh, with this thing stuck on my head, I don't look like a rat. I just look silly.
Better try again, B1. We'll be right back, Rat.
Hello again, Lulu.
Have you seen Maggie's new nest?
Next, the bananas asked Morgan if he had a hat.
Hat for Rat.
Something rat-like.
And not too small.
What about this?
Oh, well, certainly looks big enough, B2.
And very rat-like, B1.
Oh, come on, B2. Let's see what Rat thinks.
All right.
Thanks, Morgan.
Thanks, Morgan.
Bye.
Let's go, B1.
There you are.
Hi, Lulu.
Hi, bananas.
But Morgan's hat wasn't quite right either.
I think we better think again, B2. I think you're right, B1.
Oh, dear.
Even though they searched all day, the bananas just could not find a hat for Rat in a Hat.
We've tried every hat we could find. Poor Rat, he'll just have to get used to being Rat without a hat.
There you are, bananas! At last, I can show you Maggie's new nest! Mm-hmm. Look!
Does that nest look very familiar to you, B1? That nest looks very, very familiar, B2.
So Rat in a Hat got his hat back, and he was very happy. And Maggie got a new and bigger nest.
I'm a rat, I'm a rat, I'm a very silly rat. I'm a rat, I'm a rat, I'm a very silly rat. No, cheese and whiskers. Oh, I can't find my pocket watch anywhere. Oh, jeez. Oh, I wondered where I'd left this. Sausages. Oh, I've been looking for these everywhere. So that's cheese and sausages. Oh, but not a sign of my pocket watch. There you are. Now, what time is it? That time already. Oh, best get back and sort out the slipper boxes. You never know who might call in.
One morning, Morgan noticed something funny about one of his favorite slippers.
Oh, no! My favorite slippers are worn right through!
Oh, no! Well, there's only one thing to do. You're going to have to go down to the shop and buy yourself a beautiful new pair of slippers.
Oh, good. This time I want red slippers.
Yes. Why not?
Amy thought it wasn't fair that Morgan should get new slippers, so she checked her slippers.
Hey, I've got a hole in my slipper too, and I want some new blue slippers this time.
So Amy went with Morgan to the Rat in a Hat's shop.
Right, red slippers, blue slippers, oh, not a problem. Now, let's see what size your feet are.
I'm size 4.
And I'm size 6.
Right, so it's blue size 4 for Amy, mm-hmm. And red size 6 for Morgan.
Yay!
Let me see. Oh dear, I've run out of blue 4s and red 6s.
Rat decided to swap the slippers.
Maybe the teddies won't notice the difference.
He put the red slippers in the 6 box and the blue slippers in the 4 box.
I'm a clever rat.
Ow! These are too small for me.
And this slipper's too big for me.
Rat, are you sure this is a size 6?
Oh, Morgan, trust me, I'm a rat.
Just a minute, Rat. This blue box says 6.
And this red box says 4. I can't wear these. They're too small.
Oh.
The cheese and whiskers. There's no pleasing some fussy people. I'm not some sort of slipper fairy.
What's a slipper fairy?
There's no such thing as a slipper fairy. He's just being silly, Morgan.
How can I get my new red slippers?
How can I get a new blue?
Did you hear that, B1?
I certainly did, B2. Slipper fairies?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking, B1?
I think I am, B2. It's trick time!
That night, the slipper fairies did visit the teddy's house.
Careful, slipper fairy 1.
Sorry, slipper fairy 2.
Then Slipper Fairy 1 put new soles on the slippers, while Slipper Fairy 2 painted them red and blue.
Won't the teddies be surprised, Slipper Fairy 1? Very, very surprised, Slipper Fairy 2.
And when Morgan woke up in the morning...
Amy! The Slipper Fairies have been! They left me some new red slippers!
Slippers.
Don't worry, we've still got enough paint left over to paint them the right colour.
Yes.
I like these blue slippers. They're my old favourite comfy slippers, but looking like new.
And I love my new old red slippers.
let's go and show Lulu our old new slippers.
Yay!
Well done, Slipper Fairy 1. Very good night's work, Slipper Fairy 2.
And the Slipper Fairies were so pleased with the job they'd done, they flew off home to celebrate.
Is everybody here? Morgan!
Present!
Check! Emmy!
Present!
Check! Lulu! Present! Check! Okay, is everybody ready?
Ready, Lulu!
Right! Forward! March!
Oh, wait a moment! We forgot the beach ball!
Oh, never mind, Morgan!
But you can't go to the beach without a beach ball!
And pajamas had nothing to do.
There's no work to do, B1, and no one to play with, B2. I wish the sun would come out, then someone might come down the beach. Look, B2, the sun's come out. My wish has come true, B1. It certainly has, B2. It happened just after you threw that pebble into the pool. You don't suppose it's a magic wishing pool, B1? Oh, I don't know, B2. I'll give it a try. I wish for a rainbow in the sky. It worked, B1. Your wish has come true, too.
When the teddies came down to the beach, they wondered what the bananas were doing.
I wish we had something to play with on this bright sunny day.
Good idea, B1. Well, throw the pebble into the pool. Oh.
Oh, dear. It doesn't seem to be working, B2.
So the teddies decided to make the bananas wish come true.
Quick, Amy, throw them your beach ball.
Look, B2!
It's a beach ball, B1! Your wish has come true!
It certainly did, B2!
I'm very hungry, B1!
I'm very, very hungry, B2!
Then I wish we had something nice to eat on this bright sunny day!
Good wish, B2!
Oh, dear, B1! Doesn't seem to be working, B2!
But maybe our something nice to eat wish is somewhere else by mistake!
Let's go and look!
Yes. Come on!
We're sorry too, Bananas, but that magic wishing pool doesn't really work.
but it made the sun come out.
And a rainbow.
And it gave us a beach ball to play with.
And a basket of munchy honey cakes.
That's our basket, and I put it there.
And that's my beach ball.
Yes. We tricked you.
Oh, dear.
Don't worry. You can play with my beach ball anyway.
Then we'll have some munchy honey cakes.
Yay!
Thank you, Teddy.
I'm glad we wished for you to come along.
They played all afternoon. Then they had a delicious picnic and waited for the first star to come out over the sea.
Starlight, starlight, first star I see tonight. I wish I may.